clickbait, but they actually 100% work. Watch it till the end to shock your friends. Holy moly, that is a pyramid and a half. Egyptians, look out. This man is coming for you. What in the world? Why would you ever need to build something this humongous? He literally built it from the very bottom of the world. And if you guys look at the top left-hand corner, his Y value there, all the way to 255. That is build max limit. What? You literally can't build higher than that. And I was placing a bucket of water on top of his pyramid. Why? Bro, that isn't gonna cover your whole pyramid. You need a lot more water to do that. That is the biggest thing I've ever seen. Wait, how? No. How did that one bucket cover the whole thing? 537 million blocks of water from just one. My brain is really struggling to comprehend what's going on right now. There's only one way to test this, and that's with a pyramid of our own. This thing is absolutely gigantium. In the video, they actually skipped time. They cut out bits and they time-lapsed the whole video. In reality, this thing is so ginormous, it can take a couple of minutes just to get to the top at normal flying speed. Now, yes, I know mine isn't made out of stone and it's ugly and there's copper and all types of things. But that's because I had to get my brain around building this. It was so confusing because there's a very specific way you have to build this pyramid for the water to continue. You see, water travels at this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 block pyramid length, and then that has to be copied over and over again, all the way to the height limit of the world. And this thing took me 24 hours to finish building. Like, I'm not even kidding, guys. Do not judge me for my ugly looking pyramid. So I'm gonna go ahead and increase my flying speed. And there we go, guys. We are now at the very top of our gigantuan pyramid. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and turn my render distance down from 30 all the way down here to, I don't know, like 10, because I get the feeling the minute we place this water, it's gonna start lagging. Down goes our water bucket, and it's going, and it just keeps going. No way. What? This is, oh my god, my game is actually lagging right now, guys. You can see here, I'm getting a total of, what, 30 FPS? Oh my god, oh no, just dropped down to 86 FPS. Nothing's working. All right, wait, I better turn down the resonance instead to like 3. Okay, that seemed to fix the problem, guys, but I can barely see anything. But look at this, the water just keeps going and going. It doesn't actually stop. This is ridiculous. Love fact number one, Minecraft water is actually broken.
Minecraft ladders on trapdoors make the ladders look like they're floating.
That does look pretty good.
On the Vanilla Tweaks website, there's a resource pack that make ladders look 3D.
That
landing on a ladder
awesome.
Removes all fall damage you could have taken.
This is
there's
the OG
way more ways
MLG.
To use ladders like parkour and decoration. Waterlocking a ladder makes it slightly
Excuse
faster than a normal
me, no!
ladder.
Apparently, Minecraft water has even more superpowers. And yes, I know technically this is a ladder fact, but water is still involved. So let's go ahead and chuck down some walls. Ba-boom. Then we're going to break out the front two blocks here and start placing down our ladders. Now, the only way to test this really is to climb up a bunch of ladders and see which is faster. So we're going to switch into survival mode so we know this is legit. And let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 seconds to get to the top. You know, that's pretty good. I mean, it's a lot faster than ladders used to be back in the day. Now we're gonna try with water. So you're gonna put your trapdoor at the front to stop it from flowing everywhere. And we're just going to waterlog this entire thing. We're also gonna need to place a trapdoor there on the top. Let's switch into survival mode. And here we go, guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 seconds to get to the top, a total 2 seconds less. Now, obviously, 2 seconds isn't the end of the world, but if you had an absolutely ginormous ladder, that could save you, like, an entire minute.
What's the hardest block to get in Minecraft?
I don't know, like a beacon?
You probably think it's the dragon egg or beacon,
oh,
but they don't come close.
Seriously?
Most players actually get the beacon or dragon egg at one point, while some blocks,
okay,
like the dried kelp block and honeycomb, most players
yeah,
don't
but those
get,
are
but aren't
to get.
Necessarily hard to obtain.
Exactly.
The hardest block to get is rooted dirt, and if you even know what that is, I bet you don't know how to get it. First, you need to get a moss block, which can only be found in 2 places, a rare trade from a wandering trader or a rare item from a shipwreck.
Seriously, that's how you get the
block? If you manage to do
block?
This, you'll then need to place the moss in an open space, then use bone meal on
but
it to generate more blocks.
Rooted dirt.
This has a chance of spawning an azalea. If it doesn't, you have to restart. If it
this
does,
so
then
complex.
Bone meal it until it grows into a tree, and
Why?
Then and only then you can get one
Are
rooted
you serious?
Dirt.
All
Meaning,
that
if you wanted to make a rooted dirt house just this big, you would need to do this 150
oh
times.
Oh my gosh. Now, how common is it for one of these guys to sell me a moss block? All right, no moss block here. Let's try another one. Bang. Nope, no moss block. Another one. Oh my goodness, this is actually red. No moss block. Try again. Still none. Still none. What? No, how many we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Still none. 7, nope. 8, nope. 9, nope. What? 10, no. 11, no. How many? Okay, that took 12 wandering traders to get one. Maybe it is better to get from a shipwreck. I don't know. Then, of course, we're going to need to grab ourselves an emerald. And that's only going to give us 2 of these moss blocks. What a deal. I don't think that was a deal. That was ridiculously hard to get. Now we're going to chuck down our moss block. Bone mill that. That gives us more moss blocks. Now, we were pretty lucky. We got 1 azalea bush. Now that we got one of those, we're going to chuck this down on some dirt and then bone mill this. Boom! That gives us an azalea tree. And finally, hopefully, guys, we should get the holy rooted dirt block. We got ourselves just 1 rooted dirt. Seriously, if you wanted to build anything with this, you are going to have to spend hours and hours doing this. You know, at the moment, it is definitely the rarest block. It might be easier once we have lush caves, but still, this thing is incredibly rare. Alrighty, what are we doing here with a shulker box and breaking the block below it? How exactly is this clickbait? We're chucking a stone roof above it, and now we're putting in a creeper. Wait, what? Did that creeper just go inside the shulker and then pop out again? What? And now he's trapping it inside. You can keep mobs inside of shulker boxes since when? Alrighty, switching into survival mode. Oh, wait, is this a trap? Oh my goodness, that is genius and really, really mean. I had no idea you could hide mobs inside of shulker boxes. Like, yeah, sure, you can place items inside, but mobs too, that is elite. So first, they broke the block underneath the shulker box. I'm assuming you do that for the creeper's legs. If it's a 1-block high mob, you wouldn't need to do that. Then we're gonna place down here 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks with a block on top. And we need to spawn our creeper, open up the shulker, and then place a block above as quickly as we can, all right? Spawn our creeper, open it up, down it goes, and block above. We have trapped our creeper inside of the shulker box. Now, if we tried using a slab, could we open it? Hey, look at that. You can actually see the creeper's head sticking out of the shulker box. That is so cute and adorable. While this is a great decoration, I'm sure you could use it with any mob you like. If you use a creeper, it also acts as a trap. So let's go ahead, break all of that open. We're gonna switch into survival mode. And so imagine your friends are coming up. You know, this is their shulker box. They're opening up looking for some items. And boom, they are screwed. Oh, I love that. That is brilliant. Ha! Genius.
Blueberries are coming to Minecraft in the new Caves Woo! And Cliffs update coming summer of 2021.
Update, guys.
Blueberries
so
can be found hanging from the ceiling
that
of lush caves.
So
they
cool.
serve the purpose
that!
Of food, so if you're down in the caves exploring and you come across these, don't worry, you're not going to starve to death now.
That
Blueberries can
know.
Also be found in chests in the
mining.
Abandoned mine shafts. Blueberries huh. also put out a block light level of 14.
I guess that
you
makes
can
sense
also use them to breed foxes.
Wait,
using
what?
Bone
Seriously?
Mill on a glowberry vine will produce glowberries. One per bone mill. So as you can imagine, you could make a really quick and easy farm with this.
No kidding.
You can only place blueberries on the ceiling. Unfortunately, they do not go on the
I
floor.
Mean, that kind
Using
of
sucks, shears
but,
is not going
I mean,
to help or hurt
the
situation.
Ground.
You can break them just as easily with your hands.
Nice.
Breaking the fruit-covered vines will produce 1 glowberry per vine.
All right.
Unfortunately, breaking a non-fruit-bearing vine will produce 0.
Oh, well,
oh,
but at least
before
that
I forget,
makes sense.
They actually stack up to 64.
Huh,
if you want
awesome.
To prevent the glowberry vines from growing any further down, all you have to do is place a string
and
just below
what?
Where it's growing.
How does that actually work? Apparently, you can breed foxes using glowberries. Where are you guys going? Can you guys play? I just want to see whether this works. Come on, one of you. Hey, look at that! We actually made ourselves a baby fox. We had 2 baby foxes. Where did that other one come from? I don't know. This is a super easy way to get baby foxes. Before this, it was actually really, really difficult. So I am actually hyped for this. Now, the other thing that was interesting is if we have a glowberry vine here that is coming it down from the roof, even though it has no fruits, we can use bone meal on it and that's gonna produce some more glowberries. And then we can just keep spamming like that. Yo, infinite glowberry farm. The other thing is apparently if we place some string below our glowberry like this, it's not going to grow. I don't understand how this tiny little string can stop that, but I do want to test it. So let's place another glowberry over here with no string, and now we're going to speed up the in-game time. So we'll do random tick speed, and we'll just bring that up to 1,000, and boom. Let's see whether the one on the left grows. All right, the one on the right is moving quickly all the way down to the ground, and the left one isn't even budging. Huh! So it is legit, guys. If you want to use them as decoration, make sure you place down some string, and then they won't grow. Too easy.
Minecraft sand, sandstone, and birch mixtures can be used as ruined
hey,
desert
that
huts.
Actually looks
sand
pretty good.
Falls through lava source blocks,
Wait,
water source
what?
Blocks,
it doesn't
and torches
stop?
If there's air below.
Since when?
Turtle eggs only hatch on sand. Sand traps can easily be made on a large
oh, yes,
scale.
These are
string
awesome.
Causes sand to somehow float.
String
Naturally spawned
again?
Floating
has
sand causes particles.
What is this absolute nonsense about torches not destroying sand, because as long as I've known, guys, I have used torches to destroy sand quickly. Look at this. You got yourself a glass block, you break that out, and the sand gets immediately destroyed. But apparently, as long as there's air below the torch, that doesn't happen. So let's go ahead and try this. We're gonna place our torch there, put a glass above, and then we're gonna place a bunch of sand. Let's see whether this works, guys. I'll dig this down a little bit more as well. So we've got plenty of room for that sand to fall through. 3, 2, 1, bang! What? What happened? How did the torch, you have failed me. Apparently it is real. I'm absolutely gobsmacked, which makes me think that maybe the other few hacks are actually also real, guys. I might actually be real. So let's go ahead and place down some structure voids, and we'll place down our water above here. All right, there's our water, guys, set up. Let's see where the sand will pass through. All right, here we go, and bang, bang, bang. Look at that, the sand goes straight through the water, no problem. Let's try some lava here, guys, and see. I would think that lava burns the sand. No, sand can pass perfectly fine through lava, absolutely no problems. I'm still shocked, guys, I am so shook. Apparently, these are the differences between Java Edition and Bedrock Edition when it comes to blocks. So let's see what we got. All right, so in Java, you can't push the chest, but in Bedrock, you can? What? Even I didn't know that. Bedrock, the snow actually falls down. Honestly, that's a nice feature. Why isn't that in Java? All right. Oh, in Java, the bell is slightly higher up. I mean, that isn't too interesting. In Bedrock Edition, if it rains, you can't light fire. I mean, that actually makes a lot of sense, but it kind of sucks if you decorate with fire because then it'll get destroyed by the rain. All right. In Bedrock, you can waterlog pistons. You can waterlog end rods. You can't do those things on Java Edition. And you can put redstone through water in Bedrock? Yo, I just assumed you couldn't do it because you can't do it on Java. Underwater redstone? Alrighty, I'm here in Minecraft Bedrock Edition to test some of these things that I genuinely thought didn't exist in any version because they didn't work in Java. First off, you can push chests. So that's connected. If we chuck a lever on there, oh my goodness. It will actually detach the chest for you, meaning you can have two chests next to each other like this, but a single chest. That's really cool and great for decoration. We're gonna need to move out of the desert biome, somewhere where it can actually rain. I did not think that through. Let's get this storm started with a little bit of rain so we can put down our fire. And already, guys, look at that. I'm trying to light my fire. It just gets immediately put out by the water. I mean, it makes sense logically, but it kind of sucks for building because you can't decorate with fire unless, of course, you try in a desert. Because I'm pretty sure so there's no rain in the desert. There's still the rainy sky, but no rain here, guys. Let's see. Here, we can light the fire. So even though we can still see some raindrops, we can light the fire in the desert. That's really interesting and strange, guys. And finally, guys, the fact that you can place redstone underwater and it actually works. This is mind-blowing to me. All right, let's place down some redstone. Oh my god, the repeaters aren't getting destroyed. I'm actually shocked right now, guys. With a block of redstone, look at that! Underwater redstone systems. This would be great for making underwater rails and all types of other mechanics. Bro, how did I not know this? Honestly, Bedrock Edition has some pretty awesome features. All right, guys, now for our next block fact, we're actually out of time, so you can watch my next video, guys, right away. I'll see you there. Until then, anyways, stream out. Bye!